Hello and welcome to all my dear students. This is our next part, that is the digestion. As I talk about in my first part, that is the five stages. One was, yes Jatin, can you recall? That was ingestion, then you are digesting it, then absorption, assimilation and finally the ejection. Now let's take all these one by one. What actually the digestion is? In digestion, you are breaking down that complex component of food into the simpler substances. Okay, that is known as digestion. You must know the definition and you must understand it, how actually it is. Why I am saying this? Because nowadays everybody in rush due to the modernization. No one having the calmness to sit quiet and to give the time to the food that you are taking in. This is the important point that you must understand, not only the students, it is for everyone. Let's see how. The digestion is what actually you are just taking in the bite. It should be small. Okay, when you are taking that food, your bite should be small and that should be chewed properly in the buccal cavity. Okay, so let's one by one discuss about it. From here, from the buccal cavity, the large molecule, the piece that you have taken, that is right now in the, it is in the form of large molecule, and after that with the help of teeth you are breaking that large molecules into the smaller ones. Okay, and there the digestion, it's a start in your mouth. It is not like that you just take in that food and digestion will start in the stomach. It's a start from the mouth. Fine, large molecules are broken down into smaller one and the energy is released. So in the digestion, it is by two ways. One is the mechanical and another one is the chemical. And lastly, you are going to absorb that. How it is? Mechanical, that is physical. Mechanically. Mechanically, can you name any part that you know that mechanically you are breaking down that food? Yes. Yes, Dharmi, can you tell me? Yes, exactly. The teeth. First of all, mechanically, physically, you are breaking the piece of food with the help of your teeth. Here, breakdown of food into smaller pieces, that involves, what is it? You have to chew it, you have to grind it. You know grinding? Your mothers are using the mixers at home, and that, what is she is doing? She is just grinding that. She is making the paste of it. You have to chew it, you have to grind it, and then it is churning. Okay, mixing with the saliva. Next is the chemical digestion. That was the mechanical with the help of teeth. Chemical, that you are using some sort of enzymes and you are breaking down of food into simpler substances, that are the building blocks. Okay, that involves the enzymes. This we will study in detail. Next is the absorption. Here the broken down food gets from digestive tract into the body, into the blood, as I said you before. So here the digestion, the absorption, there the oral cavity, this part, your buccal cavity, that is the oral, that stays for the mouth. Mechanical digestion start from here. Large pieces are you able to see here? These are broken down into smaller pieces. Then in the stomach, still more smaller. Mechanical as well as enzymatic. Enzymes act on it. Lastly, in the small intestine, still smaller. And here again the enzymes act on that food for complete absorption and digestion. Chemical digestion, you can see from here, the main role in this part, the liver, the gallbladder, this is the green color where a small pouch like structure is present, that is attached to the liver. Here when the liver is going to secrete the bile juice, that is being stored in the gallbladder, and when it is come into use, it is then secreted. And here, this leaf-like structure, this is the pancreas. Okay, fine. This is the chemical digestion that will going with the help of the enzymes. So here, right now, I have a question for you. What do you mean by alimentary canal? If I ask you, what do you mean the alimentary canal? What you are going to tell me? It is a continuous canal. You can see from here the human digestive system, that the food you are taking in through mouth, then the continuous canal, alimentary canal or digestive canal, that is one and the same thing. Where the name comes, the canal, that is a, here it is continuous. It is not like split in between. It is a continuous form. Starts from buccal cavity, that is the oral cavity, or you can say from the mouth itself. Then the food pipe or the esophagus, then to the stomach, the J-shaped as we have seen, then to the small intestine, and lastly, then large intestine, and finally the anus. So this continuous canal is known as the alimentary canal or the digestive tract, you can say this. So here, next is the human alimentary canal. This figure we have seen earlier, but right now focus here what we have studied. You can see from here, this is the tongue, and next, tongue, this is present where? In the buccal cavity, in the mouth. Okay, mouth, that is also known as buccal cavity. Don't get it confused with that, even the oral cavity too. This is then in continuation a pipe like structure. This is the esophagus. Then esophagus goes to the J-shaped organ, that is stomach. And the stomach, this here, the small intestine. Stomach and small intestine, they have the sphincter. Sphincter, what do you mean that? It has a gate. It is not like it just keep on open. From here at the end, I'll just show you again, that at the end of the esophagus and the stomach, there is sphincter. Sphincter is a gate. It is not just open all the time. It just keep closed. When you are just taking that food, slowly, slowly, bit by bit, it just goes down to the stomach. And then when from the stomach, it want to go to the small intestine, then again the sphincter will open. But there's a difference. This sphincter is larger and this one is smaller, because slowly, slowly, it will digest the food. Okay. And here, to the small intestine, the gallbladder, that is having the bile juice, liver secrete this juice, and the pancreas, that is lying just below the stomach. This reddish brown color or brown color organ, that is the liver and is the largest organ. Okay, after that the small intestine. The small intestine, as I am saying the small, but actually it is not small. It is big, but it is in the coil form. Okay, it is in the form of the pile, and the coil form, why it is small name? Because of the narrowness. The small intestine is narrow. It is not wide. It is narrow. That's why the name small intestine. Clear? Next, from small intestine, this organ is known as the large intestine. Why the name large? It is not actually the large, but it is having the small area covered, but large because of the wide surface area. The large intestine is the wide. And after that, lastly, the rectum, where the undigested food is stored, and lastly defecated through the anus. This is the how, one by one I am going to show you. This is the buccal cavity. Okay, and as you just eat the food, this is shown here, what exactly? Pizza. But you are not supposed to eat it. I'll just give you the reason later on in the next slides why you should not eat. So here, this the food taken it through the buccal cavity. Here you can see the flap. This flap is the epiglottis. The food in the bolus form, epiglottis just shut down. I think it is clear to you right now that when we are eating the food, that it converted into bolus, ball structure, and it slips down to the food pipe esophagus. It is not going to the trachea, to the larynx. It is just avoiding how? By putting the epiglottis flap on the end. Here, the digestion in the mouth, as we have done, that it starts with the teeth itself. And now the basic and the important thing, you should know about the teeth. What and how many types of teeth you have, and according to the age group also. And this is the dental formula, how you can calculate it. The front teeth, front four, these are known as the incisors, and their function is to bite it, okay, to cut the food. And these are canines. Canines, these are pointed one, and these are meant for only tearing. These are prominent in the flesh eaters. But why we have this? Do you think about it? Let me tell you the answer. This is a vestigial organ. Even in our body, there are many others that are vestigial. Vestigial organ is that organ that is not meant for our use, but that has been developed so far in our ancestors. Because you know, our ancestors, they were having the habit of flesh eating. But now, due to the span of time, it has become now reduced and it is of no use. So canines, these you will see in the tigers, these are prominent. These are the teeth that are after the adjacent to the incisors. So canines, these are for eating, for the tearing the flesh. After it, two premolars, these are meant for grinding the food properly to make it into the paste. And later on, it's a molars. These are larger than the premolars, and these are not in case of child. Okay, in case of infant, these are not there. These are in the case of adults. Finally, the third molars, and third molars, these are not in case of all, some of having the by the span of time, but the some of get it later on in the age. So here I was talking about, this is the all the how the structure of the teeth inside your mouth. Here, teeth, incisors, these are two, canines, one, on both sides, molars, two. And here, for the child, if I want you to, if you I want that you just tell me the dental formula of the child, that will be, what is it exactly? 2, 1, 2. 2 means the 2 incisors, 1 is canine and 2 is the molars. Upper jaws and the lower jaws. It is not like we have the only one pair of teeth. We have the teeth there on the upper jaws only and the lower jaw. So there will be 20. And in case of permanent teeth in adult, these are 32. 3 addition, that is the premolars. After premolars, the molars are being added. So this is what about the dental formula, the teeth structure inside our mouth. This is how, this is the incisors, 4, and after that, here these are the canines, and then the premolars and the molars. Tooth decay. This I am going to take in our next lecture. Till now, you have to just keep in mind the structure of the teeth, and you have to write down the dental formula for the child as well as the adults.